तेरी मेरगा बोलना तुझ आगे अरदास गुरु गुरु वाहे गुरु गुरु रामदास आद गुरे नमे जुगाद गुरे नमे सत गुरे नमे श्री गुरु देव नमे वाहेगुरु जी का खालसा. In spite of the fact we have a hope that sooner or later we will be visiting the Akal Takhat, but still we sing the song, "When I shall walk on the cold marble again," is a real expression of longing. Longing to belong is the spiritual side of the man, which not only gives him the prosperity, the power, but give him a perpetual dimension in which human lack, because of the insecurity, because of the low level, mediocre level of consciousness. Try to understand that each one of us has a soul, each one of us has a mind, and each one of us has bodies, mental, spiritual, physical, subtle, all combination. We have a life, the breath of life, without which we cannot even live. Our real master, our real employer, our real relative, our real owner is the breath of life. Moment the real owner, the master, the breath of life abandons our body, the mortal falls. The immortal leaves the soul. It takes the shelter of the subtle body, and subtle weight leaves. The human has all the designs and ambition, it's gone. The purpose of being human in this life is to become immortal. There have been human, by example, who trusted in God, who believed in God, who dwelt in God, and their perpetualness is still remembered. They are called prophet, messengers, guides, teachers, spiritual, non-factual. They were factual people who brought home the realization of man's concept. Because you must understand how beautiful this earth is, and jobs here, and richness here is beautiful Maya, and we should have it. Maya Moni Jag Thagauli Chalya Sare Sai. This is the concept of this Maya. And some people do not love it to the extent they do not want to move out at all. They tie their lion cloth and they went into a mountain and they live by whatever they can get by. And they do that kind of stuff. And there are some people who just show off their spirituality to everybody. And they do kind of love. But that is all is total physical. That's a Maya. Spirituality has more Maya than anything else you can see. And I was talking to somebody and he said, "I freaked out with God. God didn't come through me. He didn't come through when I called on God." I said, "Here is a contractor who wants to deal with God. Nak nath khasam hath kirt takke de jahan dana kaan thana nanaka sache." We are just like a camel has a nail in his nose, and that is like there's a string to it, and the man very politely keep that string, and the camel, though very powerful, a high, tall, big animal, starts walking behind it. And this is that in our nose there is a little nail with a string. Kirt takke de. Kirt is action to survive. Any action we do to survive is called kirt. Kirt takke de. Kirt gives us push. pushes us through. Jahan dana taan khana. Where the written food is, there we'll eat. Nanaka sache, Nanak, that is the truth. But we are planning. We are planning to become immortal on the earth. But we forget the earth is a reflection of heavens. Let us suppose that again the earth will face that what it faced in the past of human history, that 42 years there was not a drop of rain. It is the story of this earth on which you live. I'm not talking of Jupiter or talking of any other planet. 42 years there was no rain. As at Noah times there was so much flood that 81 foot water came on the planet earth. Nau neze pani chadhaya uj ubad gujala. 9 feet, 9 foot is the one lens. The 9 lenses the water came up, rushing. And the entire the planet side of the humanity, the living, everything was washed away. It is called break of the North Pole. Ice cap broke and everywhere there was. But there was a time also which took 42 years of no rain. And that's why you are sitting in this small sea here. You call it Espanola or Santa Fe. And this all, everything here dried up. So what I mean to say, if the rain doesn't come from the heavens, or you call it sky or space or top, for a couple of years, you won't have a chance to survive in the land, doesn't matter what. Even now people are complaining, because of the drought, water table has gone down and things are topsy-turvy. However, heavens and earth has a relationship as Maya and the self has the relationship, as the mortal and immortal has the relationship. Immortal is the expression of the mortal. Don't confuse yourself with God. Rich is that who has the reach. Immortal is that who has reflective to the mortar, the immortal exist in the person here. Question is here and now. Your tomorrow is what you have done today. And how you took care of it yesterday. Otherwise tomorrow. There are people here, they are so scared and so angry. They do not even know what God is. And they are spiritual people. You talk to anybody, they will convince you little bit there. Even the atheist who doesn't believe in God will convince you for hours why that person is atheist. I once had a talk with an atheist and 3 hours we talked between me and that person. And I was doing something, I took that from a movie theater, that clicker. When a movie theater, you go into a movie theater, the man on the gate, as many people go, clicks. And then later on, he comes and see, tell the ticket seller how many tickets they have sold or how many people have gone in. They used to count seats before. Now they don't do. They do it by clicker. You might not have noticed it. So I just borrowed a clicker. And any time I say, I don't believe in God, I don't know God, I don't understand God, I started clicking. And I pressed the hand, and that's all I wanted to do, I was doing. And he never understood what I'm doing. In the end, when we conversed with each other, and he said, I'm sorry, you totally believe in God. From your conversation, I have understand you are a good debater, but I really not convinced there is a God. And I just took that thing up and read. I said, my God. He said, what? I said, you named God 400 times between me and your conversation. And I don't think I did that much. He said, how do you know? And I took the clicker in front of his, I read the number. I said, what do you mean? It's a 400. I said, yes, it's a very even number. Prayer number, 4 is prayer, 00 means infinity. Whenever you said God, from your, indirectly, indirectly, I don't care. I clicked. And look how many times you denied God or you accepted God. And then I told him the Peter story of the Saint Peter. I said, God wants to know who meditates on Him in trust and faith. And when we say meditate, it means we clear our mind of our garbage. There is not one thought you should always think that your mind will not cloud up with different varieties of stress and strain, demands and needs, insecurity. I think the people who think they are not insecure, they are not this, they are in ecstasy, they are in this, that, I think they are statues. I think if you get up in the morning and get up in an absolute negative mind and conquer it in 1 second, you are much more a saint than the saint himself. I think you must have a virtue. Virtue of life is not to relate to insecurity. And I tell you why. This is all spirituality, I understand. If you do not relate to insecurity, security, which is God, come through. And if you infinitely do not relate to insecurity, the infinite security, which is God, shall be handy. Choice is yours. I can make your choice. And in Sikh Dharma, the very presence of Akal Takht, the undying throne, shows you the real rulership of God. We celebrate the day today to commemorate the memory that Akal Takht made itself the sacrifice. And circumstances and environments are changing so fast. Whole world is going through the changes. Watch my words, in 1972, I told you very politely that 72, that 84 and 88 are the harshest periods. Yes, they were. And look, 1 year, 89, now we are entering 90. Look what has happened in that 1 year. Can you ever amazingly could understand that all these things which has happened? I was in Berlin, I went to that church to see. They told me, no, let us go to that victory gate, which they removed the wall. And I said, within the end of the year, this place will be all open again. It has to happen. And all those people, they came here, they said, yes, we believe. When you came and you stood on that stand in that church, you said, this wall is not going to stay. This is a man-made thing. God doesn't want it. And we believed then and we believe now. Ever you thought that most super two powers, who was talking nothing for animosity for years, are now do not know how to talk friendly? They forgot how to talk friendly. Now they are talking friendly, but they sometimes do not know how they talk friendly. Yes, we are friends and we have understanding and things will come out, but still we have to walk with caution. There are a lot of people here who say Satnam to each other with caution. There are a lot of people who have built psychic Berlin walls between each other. There are a lot of people who have their governments, and if you tell them to expand or contract, they like that guy who was 40 years Romanian chief. I do not want to name it, just Chisuscu something, the funny guy. They are just like that. They think they know all. They are immortal. They are forever on the earth. They will never go away. Everything is because of them. If they tilt the balance, the whole universe will go away. There's a very beautiful Chinese proverb. Chinese says, we know all is that all is, but we have to say something to be something. So what we have done, God created an infinite universe and we created an infinite insecurity. It is so much, I was going to share with you that the most beautiful thing is that we are not master of our strength. We are slaves, we are actually prisoners of our weaknesses. And we are so insecure, our weaknesses, our likes and dislikes. I tell you, you might be meeting some people, they're very beautiful, they're intelligent. I had a very shocking experience once. I went to meet a man of caliber, America knows him, and in his office, you walk through a long corridor. I went through that corridor, and both sides of the corridor are his PhD and his achievement, totally beautifully decorated on a wood and a glass, and it's so prominently enlarged, done that even a man with absolutely very bad eyesight can very well read. Then you go to an office, the office walls have just in the corners there are four or five beautiful pieces of art. The walls are decorated with his whole stuff. And I was very appreciative. Then my psychology came handy. I said, this man has to do this facade. There must be something wrong with him. Otherwise, why a man should waste so much time to convince that he's very well read? Yes, the idea was true. Within 7 minutes of conversation, I say, oh God, I'm dealing with the egomaniac who even doesn't know how to spell it. He told me, oh yeah, you come from India. I say, yeah, originally I'm from India. Oh, what do you know of the Western world? We are different. I said, you know, I had a sense of humor. I said, I don't see two noses on your face. There are only two eyes. This is something different. Me and you have same thing. He said, I mean, East is East, you know. I said, you are very mistaken. My East is New York. And my West is Tokyo. Honolulu, which one are you talking about? You all won't believe it. I have never seen a man nonplussed so badly that he couldn't say another word for about 3 minutes. He looked at me and looked at me. And I said, you are doing tratic? He said, what is that? I said, it is a yogic science in which you fix your eyes and you don't move. Oh, I'm doing something Eastern. I say, yeah, East is not that bad. Sun rises from there. So, though sunset is very beautiful, but sun rises from the East. And in the West, people sleep very late. They never see sunrise. So don't be upset. His total idea to convince that he's special, environment are special. I could see when the door opened and I went in for the first step. All along. So what I'm trying to tell you is that you have a little scheme in your head what you want to be. All right, let us establish this, that you have a scheme as a mortal. And you want in your hidden society and self a idea to be immortal. And that is where God comes in. God doesn't belong to those who believe in it or trust in it now. God belongs to those who have a very humble, hidden thought that everything is God. God doesn't belong to you or to your existence. I'm sorry to tell you that. You are the most stupid, idiot animal, not worth a worm which died yesterday. I'm telling you in the most polite religious language. And if you just want me to go a little further, it'll be illegal on my part to say that. If you do not have this subtle little ray of light deep in you, that all is God, the worst, the best, the good, the bad, and you don't exist, moment of non-existence is salvation of self into the flow of infinity. As a human, I am still searching a man who lives his spiritual status. I am deeply searching. And don't misunderstand me. I search in myself too. Your spirit is pure. It's part of God. Therefore, no way you have to find God. You have already found it in you. That's your master. That's your employer. When I see people buying Christmas present, I like it. They enjoy Christmas. They give each other presents. In the name of the spirit. You know that Santa Claus is more known to the world as well as Mickey Mouse. They are the polarities. The most popular items on this planet Earth in 1990 are Santa Claus and Mickey Mouse. You know both don't exist? There's no such thing as Santa Claus. Is man created, and it got created in Manhattan and in Bronx area? Some people overbuilt their socks and they want to sell it. And some people wanted to sell it. Manhattan firm called the Bronx firm. Hey guy, what should we do with this stuff? The guy came with a cartoon and with the idea of Santa Claus, and the socks are going to come through the chimney in every person's life. And do you believe in whole year what we sell, in 1 week we sell equal to that? 1/3 of the wholesale of everybody is sold at Christmas time. What is there in the Christmas? A spirit. They gift each other in the name of spirit. That's why Christmas look good. You call it Christ, Jews call it something else, Sikhs call it Guru Gobind Singh birthday. Everybody gets to that time when sun is smaller and night is longer. Man has created something to relate to the light and the spirit. That's all it is. I'm asking, why can't we do it all the time? What is the difficulty in us? Why can't we not figure out that God is still the owner of this planet Earth? He rotates the Earth, He will take care of the routine. I know 99% of you don't believe it, what I'm saying. I cannot disbelieve it because that is my whole practical life. I have to go by my experience. I cannot go by your experience. But I urge you, it is not that time has not been cruel with me. It is not that space has not betrayed me. It is not that I have not faced debauchery on every step of my way of life. I'm not trying to tell you that I'm a hero. Not at all. I'm telling you that life has the most cruel confrontation. But within you, like in the burning desert, there's a little well of water which is cool, calm, and it has few palm trees with dates full on it. It's oasis. So please do not lose the living life in the diagram of perpetual insecurity. Actually, people who believe God are worse when they are insecure. They are worse than the atheist. At least atheists are honest. They openly deny there is no God. But those who believe in God and are insecure, they are the worst. Let me tell you something which is very, very going to be very, very true. And I don't want you to normally go away, off your way to believe me. Normally you quote me later, oh yeah, he said it, we didn't listen to it. But normally you have your own ideas about life. But now it is a very serious situation. Our ears of prosperities are hid. We can damage ourselves by relating to our past, uptight, calamities which we have faced. It is not only that we only went through the financial crisis as whole nation, as a Khalsa nation, as Sikhs, but we gave 80 some thousand people They sacrificed their life. Innocent people. People who had nothing to do with anything. They were innocent, young, promising people of tomorrow. They lost their lives. But that's over with. But now even they do not know what to do. A lot of things are coming to light which are explaining. But still, Akal Takht stand twice incomplete. It was attacked, sacrifice was virtual, and then it sacrificed itself again. And it stand with us exactly in that status as we are. It's a holy symbol of our royalty and spirit. But on the other hand, it stands still without a golden dome and without completion. It's remind us that now the time has come when things will complete themselves, and that is the time their spirit is required. I'll ask you to start year 1990 with a one promise. Every day you will give up your little ego and you believe little bit in infinity. All right, I agree with you, infinity is vague and fake and nobody knows it and it is too much and man cannot take it. I understand that. And I understand that you all have to work hard, you have children, you have families, and you have challenges. I'm going to say, I know you are the world. I'm not denying you that privilege, but I'm asking you, why don't you give the chance to the Master, the guardian angel, the God who created you, to fix up your tomorrow? Give it a little chance. You have done 20 years. You have conformed yourself to a reality. You have come to an understanding. In 20 years now, the demand of the time and space is that you should every day trust infinity a little bit and give God a chance. I tell you my own story. One day, I was going through book very fast, sitting under a street light. And I didn't have anything for putting but marker, book marker. And these little things which fly with the light. When I open the book, I just screen through and one will fall in it and sit there. So next day, I handed over the book to the owner. I said, thank you very much for lending the book. I've gone through, I think I can go through the exam very well. But this book has a lot of markers. So don't, I couldn't tell them to go away. I couldn't tell them. They wanted to be here. There must be a purpose. Later on, he passed very good and I got good numbers. And he said, you know, I went through that book and I opened where those things were and I just read those paper and there were all the questions. I said, you know, these things in the heavens became the markers that night and I didn't know what to do with this stuff. So I told you. He said, I didn't open the whole book. You know how big it is? I just went through those pages and I was fine. Sometime, little things, small things, means all the things. So let us start year 1990 with one simple message. Let us love ourselves in a very small way and let us love everybody all the way. Let us trust little bit. I mean, I know you care for friends, you care for your jobs, you care for your children, you care for future. There's not a one item on the menu you do not care. But I just want to tell you, don't forget the owner of the whole thing is God Himself. The spirit, the breath of life. Your ego is not your owner. I know sometimes you act very obnoxiously in most belittle way when it comes to challenge to your ego. Whatever you cannot handle, you handle it very angrily. And anger gives you insensitivity and immunes you and cuts you off from the inflow of the infinity. Anger is not anything but the energy you want to use for your life every day. You blow it up in one day. And anger is many ways. There are one anger which are very evident, visible, in 10 minutes person blow up like a volcano. There are other angers very subtle. They are most dangerous people. Their anger is inside. They are manipulators, jealous, angry people. Anger has many vicious ways to come and eat up the human being because it's the life force. It is what they call the devil. It's each at the devil. It takes away from you your will and competency to be loving, to be sharing, to be trusting, to be understanding, to be flowing. All that is gone because of your, it's called cold anger. We call it white anger. White anger is a state of mind in which you are very angry to the very core of yourself. And therefore, because you are core of anger with your own spirit and soul, therefore you pretend that anger, with share that anger in everything. And sometimes it shows up in your work. Sometimes it shows up in your art. I met in Avakarki that day an artist. I couldn't believe it. He created marvelous pieces of art. But they show anger, anxiety, pain, that even the touch of those things. It was proven that man has gone through nothing but tears in life. Each day, your mental action, mental thoughts, shall be manifested in each tomorrow. You perhaps do not know. It's called act of karma. Each day, one negative thought will create one negative scene tomorrow. Because the cycle of the earth on the axle is 24 hours, and psychomagnetic field and psychomagnetic identity must classify within 24 hours. And psycho-electromagnetic field and psycho-electromagnetic identity in project must manifest itself in 1 year. That's the orbit on which the earth rotates around the sun. These are two laws you can't change. That's why the Siri Guru Granth, the word as human wisdom to purify our mind, needs to be in your heart. It should be with you in memory. It should come handy when you freak out, when you blow up your fuse, when you get scared. Because at that time, as a Sikh, is it dangerous. You are forgetting the basic fundamental teaching of Sikh Dharma, Ang Sang Vaiguru. It's very surprising. You feel your friends are with you. You feel your wisdom is with you. You feel your intellectual is with you. You feel your intelligence is with you. You feel everything is with you. You feel your children are going to be with you forever. Your home is going to be forever. Your water supply is never going to go away. Your pipes can never burst. I mean, you feel everything is with you. You never feel that God is with you. You chant Vaheguru. That is your Guru Mantra. And you never feel it is with you. Sometime I was very kind to somebody. I said, the person said, I do not know what to do. I said, do nothing. Just to everything say Vaheguru. Ang Sang Vaheguru. God is within me and with me. every breath of life 15 times per minute come and tell me so, and I don't want to feel it. What has gone wrong to our feelings? But what has happened in 1989 is an old story. Let us start the year 90 with one word only. Once I was told that in real estate there are three things which work: location, location, location. And in prosperity, three things work: security, security, security. Because security manifests prosperity. Security manifests the entire manifestation. Because security is the rule of harmony. You have to secure two wheels so that they can go into absolute harmony. You have to get everything to the pivot, so this the force can move. And there are no two forces other than the lens and the lever. Lever moves which you cannot move. Lens see which you cannot see. And you have all those two powers. The only thing you lack in your life is that you are not secure. A person who is not secure has nothing to do with harmony. Some of you think that status, the money, the wealth, and the friends, and the relationship, all that can work it out. My friends, it's not true. If the axle breaks, there is no car yet made which can make to the destination. If your tire busts out, you can go on it. There are a lot of ways you can maneuver your life, but you have no life. You are rather a burden to life when your axle breaks. And every life has axle. And that is the Spirit of God, the breath of life, the most important mortal has to see. Immortality is the axle of life. It will serve us here and hereafter. Stupid person should not think that he is here to be here. No, we are here to give the message of heavens. We are here to take with us the goodness into heavens. It's a journey, my friend, through which we are going. I am very fortunate to be with you and to be in the presence of the Siri Guru Granth. And your prayers are virtues. They gave me the extension of life and they gave me to serve you. And it will be recorded in the time of the history that when the golden temple gates got closed, so my arteries, and so God gave you a chance to do and test your prayer, and your prayer brought me from the death back to the life. I'm not denying that my life is because of me, or in my horoscope tells so, and it's not true. The truth is, my life each day is because of your prayer and your longing and your love for me, and you are asking me to be with you. That proves that your prayer works. And that is my personal testimony, that your prayer works. But it works for me, it definitely works for you. And prayer is the power. Believe me. Read my lips if you have to. Let us be kind and gentle to the fact of reality. God is never going to abandon the planet Earth. Therefore, he is not, creator is not going to abandon the creation and the creatures. Let us start our today with ecstasy of consciousness and feeling of oneness with God and with each other. Let us make a resolution that each day we'll say goodbye to insecurity a little bit, and we'll rely on security a little bit more. And that each day, that little bit in a small way, shall go all the way in the end you will find it is multiplied by 365. That many days are there. But if you're really smart, do it by the hour. If you think you are really smart, do it by the minute. And if you have a real computer consciousness, do it by second. Time has come, my friends, to realize what we have come to realize on the earth. And time has come to realize heavens are on the earth. And watch my words. Trust them not though you won't want to. Those who do not realize heavens on the earth do not know where heavens are. And cycle of 8.4 million lifetime is the reserve path. And many, many times they go through this cycle for nothing. I am very grateful to somebody who gave me the videotape on life. And that videotape you all should have. And I like to send a copy to you too, or you can have it. It tells you all about life, how from a little point, a little mucusy point, we all started and how many lives we have gone through. If you just see that, I think you will not like to go through that again. I mean, how many of you want to be eel in the bottom of the ocean? And how many of I want you to be like to be all that stuff which they show? Thank God you have all come out of it consciously. I hope the 1990 should give you a message that we are done well for 2 decades. We have done a great service to humanity by serving ourselves, try to uplift ourselves into the spirit of God, in believing that there is one God and His entire His. That is the first word of Sikh Dharma, Ekomkar. There is but one God and total universe is His creation. Now is the time to come out with the love and affection. And each day, do it. Because I want to ask you that. Today I see everybody has that little book. They call it day management, table management. So every day you make your appointments on it. Make first opening appointment at the middle of the day to calculate how much insecurity I have given up and how much security I have trusted. Make an appointment for 15 minutes with that. Organizer, they call it. Yes, yes, yes. And they are very costly these days. I saw one organizer, I couldn't believe the price. And it tells you everything. And when you open the page, it starts singing to you, it's cheering you up, it sings you songs. And when I opened it on the Christmas day, it started singing Christmas songs. It gives you 1 minute of the day, best inspirational song. Unbelievable. Just open the page, there's nothing you have to do. There's whole, in the body of it, there's a whole chipmunk situation going on. And it does the whole thing a man can do. And amazingly, if there's an urgent appointment, so urgent that you don't want to miss it, you write then and you press there is a certain mark as urgent. Whether it is in your bag or it is your hand, it will create in a hell till you read it. It won't stop, doesn't matter what. Till the batteries of that thing lost, but that is too long to understand. So with that kind of modernization and mechanizing in life, don't you understand? Time has come for you to facilitate your own thoughts, to feel God is with you. And one learn I ask you to learn. One word, one line. I'm not asking you to, whether if you do pranayama for 30 hours, you're fine. Or you can fly in the air, you will be wonderful. Or you give $1 billion as charity, you will be nice. I'm saying nothing. Don't do anything for me or believe me or trust me. For your own sake, every day, there are 8 hours of the day you work. 8 hours of the day you do everything. And 8 hours of the day you do a lot of things. There are 24 hours. You make it a point that one plus for that, the infinite, 24 for you. 25 times you have to say to yourself, Ang Sang Vaheguru. In 24 hours, you have to say 25 times to yourself, not for me, not meditating on God, not closing eye, not doing any yoga, not, absolutely, you can do it while sitting on a toilet seat. It doesn't matter. It's all you. You have to have no ceremony for it. But make it a promise that the whole year of 1990, you will say every day 25 times, Ang Sang Wa He Guru. Ang Sang Wa He Guru. These are five words. These are five sounds. It will develop intuition in you that you need it. It will let you see the unseen, hear the unheard, and know the unknown. My prayer is that we are walking on a path of infinity. My blessing is, let us make it together. Vaheguru Ji Ka Khalsa.
Vaheguru Ji Ki Fateh.
Vitas kasamadi nuryaso kurso jatiye turidite sache patshao mal janam janam di katiye sajna sacha patshao sir shandeshao Jis paas betiye soye, sab na daave sao. Ad gure name, jugad gure name, sat gure name, Sri Guru Deve name. Sat Sri Vahe Guru Sahib Jiyo Suhi Mahala Panjwaan Jinnamoe Brahmand Kandtahu Me Pao Rak Leo Eo Bikki Jiyo De Apna Nao Jinnamoe Brahmand Kand tau me pao, rakh leo eo bikki, jiyo de apna nao rao. Jate nahi ko sukita ke, bache jao, chod jaye jo sagal ko, fir fir laptao. Karo kirpa karna pate tere har guna gao Nanak ki prabh benti sad sang samao Karo kirpa karna pate tere har guna gao Nanak ki prabh benti Sad Sang Samao Vaheguru Ji Ka Khalsa Vaheguru Ji Ki Fateh
Suhi fifth channel of light She who has bewitched the world and continents in her clutches I have fallen O my Lord save this sinful soul of mine by blessing it with thy name pause She who has bewitched the world and continents in her clutches, I have fallen. O my Lord, save this sinful soul of mine by blessing it with thy name, pause. I pursue her who has made no one ever comfortable. She who forsakes all, to her I cling again and again. Have mercy on me, O the Lord of compassion, that I may sing thine divine praise. This is the prayer of Nanak, O Lord, that he may remain absorbed in the saints' congregation. Have mercy on me, O the Lord of compassion, that I may sing thine divine praise. This is the prayer of Nanak, O Lord, that he may remain absorbed in the saints' congregation.
Vaheguru Ji Ka
Khalsa, Vaheguru Ji Ki
Fateh.
Thank you. Dhamma Siri Guru Granth Sahib Ji. 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 Dhamma Siri Guru Granth Sahib Ji.
Vaheguru Ji Ka Khalsa.